morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship this morning on this nice sunny day. We thank Bridget for filling in again this week. Kevin is out sick, so hopefully he recovers soon. So we are keeping him in our prayers this week. Good luck to all those teachers and parents and grandparents who are sending kids back to school this week and next week. We keep them also in our prayers. Let us begin with the confession and forgiveness. Please stand as you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, the one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Gracious God, have mercy on us.
We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life.
Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith.
Amen.
Our gathering song is God is Here, number 526.
Promise me.
bread of heaven that gives life to the world. Give us bread always, that we may live in us and we in him, and that, strengthened by this food, we may live as his body in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated for the anthem.
From Ephesians. So then, putting away falsehood, let all of us speak the truth to our neighbors, for we are members of one another. Be angry, but do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and do not make room for the devil. Thieves must give up stealing. Rather, let them labor and work honestly with their own hands, so as to have something to share with the needy. Let no evil talk come out of your mouths, but only what is useful for building up as there is need, so that your words may give grace to those who hear. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were marked with a seal for the day of redemption. Put away from you all bitterness and wrath and anger and wrangling and slander, together with all malice. And be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ has forgiven you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowd, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Then the Jews began to complain about him because he said, I am the bread that came down from heaven. They were saying, is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How can he now say, I have come down from heaven? Jesus answered them, do not complain among yourselves. No one can come to me unless drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise that person up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they shall be all be taught by God. Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Very truly I tell you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
What fills your life? Maybe a better way to think about it is, what excites you? Okay, as kids, we know that the little things excite us. A new toy, going to a new place, going to grandma and grandpa's house, going to the park. But as adults, what excites us? What excites you? Or maybe what inspires you? Okay, for me, going to Disneyland inspires me because of all the creativity and all the wonder that they create for people. Why can't we do that for churches too? That's the part that excites me. I get excited when people learn something new about the Bible. I get excited when kids answer the question before I even ask it. Because then it means I have to come up with something better for them. I love it when people are excited about Jesus. I get excited when I get to learn something new about how to develop a website or change things. I get excited when I create a photo album online for a friend or family because I'm doing something for someone else. It's that end of product. So what excites you? What inspires you? I mean, we have years and years of experience in this room and people watching. Over the years, something has to excite you and motivate you to do something, or else you're left hungry. You're left feeling empty. There's no meaning to our life. We continue with these passages about bread, and we're gonna continue with them for a few more weeks. And Jesus, in John's Gospel here, uses the phrase, I am. This phrase is used 7 times to identify who Christ is. Not only does Jesus describe himself as the bread of life, but also the vine, the good shepherd, the gate, the living water, the light of the world, and the resurrection. That I am phrase goes all the way back to the Exodus. When we see Moses at the burning bush, when Moses asks God's name, and God replies, I am who I am. Jesus adds more fuel to this fire when he reveals no one can come to God but through him. And the people of that day, especially the Jewish people, couldn't believe that the son of Mary and Joseph would claim to be the bread of life. They know Jesus. They know who he was. What was this unbelievable claim that he was making? God's doing something new among them. And the crowds were astonished. That was a huge claim. I mean, I could go and say, well, you can't see Jesus until you bow down to me. And that would be an astonishment in this day and age. And there are people who do that. And we have to filter through all that. Because does the crowds gather? It's really why we come to church or why we gather as God's people. Because we want to be fed. We don't want to be left hungry. I know that probably earlier in this pandemic we were feeling hungry because we worked together, but we worked together just, you know, apart. But now we're filled just a little bit more. Christ fills us because we're together. How exciting is that? And if we're not excited, why aren't we excited? Jesus gives us that bread, that nourishment, that rains down from heaven, that manna in a sense. Christ here is referring to and looking at his ending, that final given for you, that crucifixion and that resurrection, that promise of new life. And we're supposed to be excited about it. We're supposed to be filled with joy. Not hungry all the time. Think about kids or families who don't have food. So in college, one of my first experiences on a retreat was taking time to fast. 12 hours, no food. We had breakfast, and then we had to wait all the way until dinner. I had never fasted or even knew about fasting in my life at all. And I didn't know what to do during that time. Well, luckily, I was with other people who had done it before, and, you know, we prayed, and we sang songs, and we had time to ourselves just to think about who Jesus was and how we're fed. But you know what? I was really still hungry. Because the other worst part of it was they were making food in the kitchen, and you could smell the spaghetti dinner, because I'll never forget it was spaghetti, coming up and seeping through this cabin that we were in. And I was like, I really want that food. That's how we're supposed to be about Jesus. That we really want Jesus in our lives. That's why I get excited when people discover something new about who God is in their life. Whether good or bad, it's still a blessing. We're fed both physically and spiritually as we come to God's table. This is a gift from God to you to share to the world, to us, to share to the world. So this week, consider how you are sharing that gift with the world. Amen. Our hymn of the day is I Love to Tell the Story, number 661.
I want to tell a story.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Rooted in Christ and sustained by the Spirit of God, we offer our prayers to the Church, the world, and all of creation. Gracious God, we offer prayers for the Church in all its diverse forms, for mission developers, new ministry starts, and all communities of faith exploring new models of ministry for the sake of the gospel, for our congregations that are facing difficult decisions about their future. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, we pray for the health and well-being of all creation, for shade trees that provide refuge from the hot summer sun, for lakes, rivers, and oceans that are contaminated by pollution, and all that lack clean water. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for those who are called to positions of authority in our legal system, for judges, lawyers, law clerks, and court employees who endure and dare give out administrative justice for all, for correction officers and prison chaplains as they deal with mercy with those who are incarcerated. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, you hear those who cry out in affliction to you, for exiles and refugees and others who face long and difficult journeys, uncertain about the future, for all who mourn the death of loved ones, for all who are sick or in any need. We remember Darlene, Fred, Sylvester, Heather, Kay, Helen, Wes, Lance, Jean, Kristen, Rebecca, Greg, Bob, and Dorothy. Surround them with your unwavering presence. Be with our bishops, Elizabeth Eaton and Andrew Taylor, and all who have been affected by COVID-19, fires and storms that rage across the country and the world, police officers and firefighters, medical professionals and all who serve in our community, all military chaplains and all who serve in our military both at home or abroad. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, we pray for this assembly, gathered both near and far around your table, for those among us who bake bread and prepare the vessels of our communion celebration, for those who bring food from this table to those who are homebound or hospitalized. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for those who have been raised to eternal life. We give thanks with all the saints in life that we praise you for the bread of life that keeps us in your love forever. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We lift these prayers and our prayers to you, O God, confident in the promise of your saving love through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share Christ's peace with one another distantly. We are so thankful and grateful for each of you being here and watching at home. Thank you for the generous gifts that you continue to bless our Saviors with. If you are here, remember you can leave your offering plates, your offering in the plate as you. We continue with communion. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The body of Christ given for you.
Amen.
The blood of Christ shed for you.
Amen.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you now and always.
Amen.
Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with our whole life. Through your name, we pray.
Amen.
As you go into week, go knowing that Jesus Christ, your Lord and Savior, King of all creation, will go before you to lead the way of your life. He will be on your right side and your left as friend, advocate, companion. He will be above you, watching over you, below you, lifting you up, giving you all that is needful, grace sufficient for the days and challenges of each experience that you have in your life. He will be behind you, encouraging you in those difficult, challenging decisions, relationships, the very real obstacles and mazes that you face. As you go into your week, go knowing that Jesus Christ, your Lord and Savior, will be around you until we gather as Christ's joyful, serving, loving people. Amen. Our sending hymn is "Be Thou My Vision," number 793.
Oh,
be to God.